Hello, everybody. Tangible God is tuning in with you today. Blissings to all my kings and queens. Grand rising all day, every day. I miss you guys. What I'm going to do today is a twin flame reading. I usually do that on Tuesday, but I was busy giving myself some self-love. How about that? Right now, I'm going to pull the overall energy for the divine masculine and the divine feminine. Universe, what headspace is divine masculine and divine feminine overall energy? Thank you guys for tuning in. I love you. Don't forget to like, vibe, and subscribe if this is your first time, second, or third time tuning in. Welcome, 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 guys. Thanks for tuning in to this video. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think. What headspace is divine masculine and divine feminine in? We got perseverance, which is four. Four is home. Four is foundation. So we have a perseverance. And the foundation at home. Okay. Then I'm going to pull what does the universe want to tell the divine masculine and the divine feminine. I'm going out of order that I'm going to actually read this, but these are, I'm going to still pull that from the numerology card, so I'm going to just keep them. Spirituality is what the universe is telling the divine masculine and the divine feminine. 77. Lucky numbers there. Okay. And let's see. Let's pull the headspace for the divine masculine. Universe, what headspace is the divine masculine in today? I love you guys. I just want to remind you to continue to meditate and take care of yourself. Make sure you're getting the ample amount of sleep. Get your sleep. Get your rest. It's very important. It's very important to take care of your body, spiritually and physically. What headspace is the divine masculine is peacekeeper. It says let go of the need to be right. Okay, divine masculine. The peacekeeper. Those were my angels and ancestor cards. Now let's pull a card for the divine feminine. What headspace is the divine feminine in today, guys? I'm just looking. I never really tripped off the moon be out and the sun is out at the same damn time. I never really tripped off of that. I mean, I have before today, but you know, when I was young, I don't think I tripped off of that too much. Universe, what headspace is the divine feminine in today? My cards are cold. It's getting cold outside and I had my cards in my car. Two cards came out. It says suffering and silence and obstacles and challenges. I'm going to go ahead and keep them both. So that's the headspace of the divine feminine. Obstacles and challenges and suffering and silence. Wow. Okay. I love you, babe. I got my heated seats on and burning my leg. Really true say about me. For my inner circle elected. from my inner circle. A lack thereof, and I don't know who I can trust. I've been trapped on. Thank you guys for being patient with me. I love you guys. Twin flame reading, guys. All about love here. Let's get this popping. On and on the low key shining. Trying to keep to myself, but you bring me out the character every time again. Okay, guys, overall energy for the divine masculine, divine feminine is 4, which is perseverance. Let's see. Okay, it says, turn it down just a scotch. It says, this card indicates a time to keep moving forward as you strive to achieve your hopes and dreams, because despite of your current challenges, success is well within your reach. Both of us, divine feminine, divine masculine, success is well within your reach. You are never given more than you can handle. Remember that. You have the strength and ability to make it through. So face your challenges head on with determination, courage, and faith. With perseverance and persistence, you can make your dreams come true. By drawing this card, you are being encouraged to cultivate mental resilience and stability. Since a calm and stable mind creates a calm and stable life, make yourself aware of negative thoughts and beliefs that are currently influencing you. And muster up the strength to develop a positive state of mind. Stay positive. In order to improve your current situation, you're being asked to adjust to and harmonize with the natural rhythms and cycles of your life. Cycles that are encouraging you to persevere through the obstacles and challenges. Call on heavenly assistance when you need it and have faith in your ability to create an exceptional life. With perseverance and persistence, I create an exceptional life. Call up on your angels and ancestors for help. I have 5 angels that I know for sure that's looking out for their mom. Okay, guys? So ask questions and look for assistance within the spiritual realm. And be persistent. Everything is possible in your life. Divine masculine, divine feminine. Persevere. Overall. Okay. Let's see. The next card we're going to go with is the headspace of the divine masculine, which is Peacekeeper. Put that card back. These are my numerology. Okay. Peacekeeper. Oh, we're going to need that for spirituality. Angels and ancestors, divine masculine headspace is peacekeepers. He's letting go the need to be right, or need to let go of the need to be right. Take it as it applies to your life. Peacekeeper. You'd rather be laid up with a baby. Let's see. Thanks for being patient with me, guys. Peacekeeper 58. The sacred ones. This is the divine masculine. Sorry, guys, about that. This is the headspace of the divine masculine. Just checking my time. I bumped the call. Okay, let go of the need to be right, divine masculine. Choose peace and happiness over the need to be right. Rather than trying to prove a point, save your energy for what's important. The peacekeeper was a wise Native American woman who was influenced by the white buffalo woman. She holds a peace pipe, which is embolic of surrendering to the need to fight and offering harmony instead. Peace. She is a soul who knows what it is to feel like under threat, to stand up for what she believes in and what's right. Her medicine helps you to take the higher road in every situation. Even if you're under pressure to make a quick decision, It is a reminder that within your hands lies the power to make the right choice for all who's involved. Divine masculine, you have that power to make the choice, the right choice for all who's involved. Okay? You have that power. Only you, divine masculine. You may be feeling an edge. You may be feeling on edge due to stressful situation. There is a warrior within you that wants to rise up, prove your point, and get the truth across. But you are being reminded by ancestors' wisdom that truth will always be revealed in the end. It's more important at this time to avoid arguments, heated discussions, where you know you will be fighting a losing battle. There is much more power in choosing to move forward from a higher perspective. This will allow you to connect deeply with the guidance within and intuition that will lead you towards the healing of a whole situation. The whole situation. Not your current situation. The whole situation, divine masculine. Okay? Pay attention. Along with wounds it may have inflicted on you, choose peace and know it's calling you. Be peaceful. Let go of the need to be right, divine masculine. Choose peace. Pick your battles. Okay? All right. This is a message from the universe for you. Don't get mad at me. I'm just giving you what spirits is telling me. Okay? That's for you, babe. That's for you, divine masculine. Now, let's go on to my beautiful divine feminines. We have obstacles and challenges and suffering and silence. Oh, my babies. 9 and 5. It's 14. It's 5. Okay. Let me go to the right deck. We're going to start with obstacles and challenges. Divine feminine. Violet, yeah, this is a violet border. This is from our spirit. So, obstacles and challenges within our spirit. Page 141. Okay, it says this card represents the obstacles, power, struggles, and challenges that you must face in order to overcome them. This could be a difficult period to get through, but it's not impossible if you open your mind and see the bigger picture of how something went wrong. Don't get caught up in it. Just pause and stand back for clarity. Observe where adjustments are required or which decisions may need to be changed to enable you to move forward in a positive direction. Life really is all about learning. Don't play victim. Please, divine feminine, do not play victim. Your life circumstances are what you made them. Take responsibility. Take the knowledge you've gained from this experience so that you can apply it to similar situations in the future. This card often comes forth when competition is around you, whether it's in your personal or business life. This is an excellent time to think creatively and ask yourself, how can I make myself shine above the rest? Take care of yourself, divine feminine. Only you can take care of yourself. Okay? Don't let nothing outside you influence you. Don't blame anyone outside you for your circumstances. Take responsibility and correct them. Stand back, look at your situation, and move forward accordingly. Okay, the next card. We have two cards for the Divine Feminine. The next card is Suffering and Silence, which is 9. These are both spiritual cards. It's all about our spirit. Yes. Oh, this is a blue. No, this is an indigo card. So this is... Okay, that one was the spirit. obstacles and challenges, spirit. This card is indigo. So let's see what this is. Suffering in silence. This is mental. So this is all in our head. 128. Yeah, mental. Suffering in silence. Okay, the number 9 denotes completion. Are you finally ready to let go of those limiting negative beliefs? Are you allowing the issues in your life to become bigger than they really are? Your mind has been doing quite a job on you lately, Divine Feminines. And even your dreams may be trying to get your attention. When you learn to let go of the worry, despair, and sense of hopelessness, a positive new way or path will be shown to you. This card follows trap in fear. The number 8 mental card, when your fears aren't confronted, your mental anguish will continue. This is a reminder to take action, trust in your soul, and the power of spirit will grasp you firmly by the hand and guide you. But you must take the first step forward, healing, and let go of the mental distress. Don't suffer in silence. Reach out for help that's available. So, Divine Feminines, whatever is going on in your mental state, in your head, in your mind, ask for help. Don't be trapped in fear, because when your fears aren't confronted, you will continue to be angry. Confront your fears and realize what it is, and don't be angry. You got to get out of that anger in order to move forward. Don't suffer in silence, Divine Feminine. Reach out for help that's available. Yes, 9 is completion. So we are, Divine Feminines, finally ready to let go of what's been holding us back spiritually. Mentally, okay? Not necessarily physically, but mentally. You got to let go of those, I forget the word, codependent thoughts, thinking, you know. It's all about you, Divine Feminine. You don't need anyone to make your life what you have made your life so far. You may think you do mentally, but in reality, you don't. It's all about you. You make the decisions. You get through your obstacles and challenges and don't suffer in silence. Move forward. Let go of worry, despair, and your sense of hopelessness. It says, this is a reminder to take action and trust that your soul and the power of your spirit will grasp you firmly by the hand and guide you, but you must take the first step toward healing and let go of the mental distress. Take the first step, Divine Feminine. And the bottom line card for what the universe is telling the Divine Masculine and the Divine Feminine is spirituality, which is 77. We're back to my numerology deck. Let's see. This is what the universe is telling the Divine Masculine and the Divine Feminine. It says, this card indicates a need to enhance your connection to the divine to improve your relationship with yourself. I just had a message about that. My last reading was about self-love. As well as your quality of life. You are not a human being having... I'm sorry, slow down, Tangie. Tangible goddess. It says you are not a human being having a spiritual experience. You are a spiritual being having a human experience. And your relationship with Source is your path to inner peace. When you find your way to God, you find your way back home. That's you, baby. That's within. By selecting this card, you are being encouraged to celebrate and strengthen your relationship with the divine in whichever way you choose. You may opt for prayer, meditation, chanting, yoga, or periods of silence and contemplation. Perhaps quiet time in nature, going on a retreat, or attending a place of worship is something you prefer. It doesn't matter which option you choose, for there is no right or wrong. Only you can know your ultimate path to God. In order to improve your current situation, you're being asked to adjust to and harmonize with the natural rhythms and cycles of your life. Cycles that are encouraging you to strengthen your relationship with the divine. You are also being urged to communicate with your lost loved ones, spirit guides, angels, and ask for assistance when required. No request goes unanswered, and no request is too big or small. The affirmation today, guys, what the universe wants to tell us both is all. My relationship with the divine is my path to inner peace. Your relationship with the divine is your path to inner peace. That goes back again to loving yourself. Make sure, guys, that you are talking to your spirit guides and your angels and ancestors in any situation you may have questions. They will come to you in a dream. No question is too small. No question is too big for your angels and ancestors to answer. God is within you. Be still and understand that you are God, okay? Thank you guys for tuning in, Tangible Goddess. Blessings to all my kings and queens, Gram Rising, all day, every day. Love you guys. Don't forget to like, vibe, and subscribe. I love you. Get away now. Normal girl.